"Pretty ridiculous," Sophie said. All the same, she couldn't resist reaching down and pressing her own tummy button to see if it worked. Nothing happened. "Dreams is very mystical things," the BFG said. "Human beings is not understanding them at all. Not even their brainiest professors is understanding them. Has you seen enough?" "Just this last one," Sophie said. "This one here." She started reading. "I has written a book, and it is so exciting, nobody can put it down. As soon as you has read the first line, you is so hooked on it, you cannot stop until the last page. In all the cities, people is walking in the streets, bumping into each other because their faces is buried in my book, and dentist is reading it and trying to fill teeth at the same time. But nobody minds, because they is all reading it too in the dentist's chair. Drivers is reading it while driving, and cars is crashing all over the country. Brain surgeons is reading it while they is operating on brains, and airline pilots is reading it and going to Timbuktu instead of London. Football players is reading it on the field, because they can't put it down, and so is Olympic runners while they is running. Everybody has to see what is going to happen next in my book, and when I wake up, I is still tingling with excitement at being the greatest writer the world has ever known, until my mummy comes in and says, 'I was looking at your English exercise book last night, and really your spelling is atrocious. So is your punctuation.'" "That's enough for now," the BFG said. "There's dillions more, but my arm is getting tired holding you up." "What are all those over there?" Sophie said. "Why have they got such tiny labels?" "That," the BFG said, "is because one day, I is catching so many dreams, I is not having the time or energy to write out long labels. But there is enough to remind me." "Can I look?" Sophie said. The long-suffering BFG carried her across to the jars she was pointing to. Sophie read them rapidly, one after the other. "I is climbing Mount Everest with just my pussycat for company. I is inventing a car that runs on toothpaste. I is able to make the electric lights go on and off just by wishing it. I is only an 8-year-old little boy, but I is growing a splendid bushy beard, and all the other boys is jealous. I is able to jump out of any high window and float down safely. I has a pet bee that makes rock and roll music when it flies." "What amazes me," Sophie said, "is how you ever learned to write in the first place." "Ah," said the BFG. "I has been wondering how long it is before you was asking me that." "Considering you never went to school, I think it's quite marvelous," Sophie said. "How did you learn?" The BFG crossed the cave and opened a tiny secret door in the wall. He took out a book, very old and tattered. By human standards, it was an ordinary-sized book, but it looked like a postage stamp in his huge hand. "One night," he said, "I is blowing a dream through a window, and I sees this book lying on the little boy's bedroom table. I wanted it so very badly, you understand. But I is refusing to steal it. I would never do that." "So how did you get it?" Sophie asked. "I borrowed it," the BFG said, smiling a little. "Just for a short time, I borrowed it." "How long have you had it?" Sophie asked. "Perhaps only about 80 years, the BFG said. "Soon I shall be putting it back." "And that's how you taught yourself to write?" Sophie asked him. "I is reading it hundreds of times," the BFG said. "And I is still reading it and teaching new words to myself and how to write them. It is the most scrumdiddlyumptious story." Sophie took the book out of his hand. "Nicholas Nickleby," she read aloud. "By Doll's Chickens," the BFG said. "By who?" Sophie said. Just then, there came a tremendous noise of galloping feet from outside the cave. "What's that?" Sophie cried. "That is all the giants zip-fizzing off to another country to guzzle human beings," the BFG said. He quickly popped Sophie into his waistcoat pocket, then hurried to the cave entrance and rolled back the stone. Sophie, peeping out of her spy hole, saw all 9 of the fearsome giants coming past at full gallop. "Where is you off to tonight?" shouted the BFG. "We is all of us flesh bunking off to England tonight," answered the flesh lump eater as they went galloping past. "England is a luxurious land, and we is fancying a few nice little English chidlers. I, shouted the Maid Masher, is knowing where there is a giggle house for girls, and I is guzzling myself full as a froth blower. And I knows where there's a boggle box for boys, shouted the Gizzard Gulper. All I has to do is reach in and grab myself a handful. English boys is tasting extra lick swishy. In a few seconds, the 9 galloping giants were out of sight. What did he mean? Sophie said, poking her head out of the pocket. What is a giggle house for girls? He's meaning a girls' school, the BFG said. He will be eating them by the bundle. Oh no, cried Sophie. And boys from a boys' school, said the BFG. It mustn't happen, Sophie cried out. We've got to stop them. We can't just sit here and do nothing. There's not a thing we can do, the BFG said. We's helpless as horse feathers. He sat down on a large, craggy blue rock near the entrance to his cave. He took Sophie from his pocket and put her beside him on the rock. It is now quite safe for you to be outside until they is coming back, he said. The sun had dipped below the horizon, and it was getting dark.